Welcome to our channel Right Click Education. In this video we will learn about angular material forms, which is also referred as mat form field element in angular material. So without any delay, let's get started. So first open your Chrome, click angular material. Now you can see this material.angular.io. Click on this link. This is the official website of Angular. You can see the component button is here on the top navbar. Click on this. By clicking on this, you will find all the elements that are there in Angular material. So in order to implement the Angular material form field, you can see we have this form field here. Click on this. So if you see, by definition, mat form field is a component used to wrap several angular material component and apply common text field style such as underline, floating level and hint messages, etc. Okay, so basically mat form field is used to wrap the different input types. Okay, so suppose you have an input, you have a text area input, you have some select boxes, you have some mat chip. So you, if you want to wrap it, you need to put those all things inside mat form field. So without discussing a lot, we will get straight back to the implementation part. So for that, click on this API, copy mat form field module, go to your VS Code, you need to paste it. So I will paste it here. Okay, copy this mat form field module. Okay, paste it here. Now let me tell you one thing. So if I wrap this input with this mat form field, then you also need to import mat input module. Okay, so you need to import this mat. I have already imported it, but you also need to check if you have imported this mat input module. Okay, and if you want to import use to wrap select boxes by this mat form field, then you need to see whether you have imported this select import, okay, which is mat select module. So you need to check if these imports are there, then you are ready to go. Okay, so I have already those imports. So let's get started, and I will click on this form field. Okay, scroll down a little bit. So you can see, right, this is input box. Let me type something. It is select box. You can select any option from it. This is text area. So in order to implement it, click on view code, copy this, go to your HTML, paste it here. So you can see we have this input box, and this input box is wrapped with this mat form field. Inside this mat form field, we have this mat label also. Okay, so whatever the heading of that form field, this label will show that. And then we have this input box where we can do some input from keyboard. And also you can see this is mat form field, and mat select is here, right? So mat select is being wrapped by this mat form field. And you can also see this text area is being wrapped by mat form field. So basically mat form field is used to create the forms where you need to wrap those input text area or mat select boxes with this mat form field. Okay, now let's go to our UI and see how it looks like. Okay, let's open a new tab. Type localhost 4200. You can see, right, we have this. This is input. We can type anything here. This is select box. You can select any option from it. This is also text area. You can type anything, right? So these are the implementations of mat form fields. Okay, so what I will do, I will use some break so that it will give us some better visibility. Okay, so now it's looking much better, right? Now I will also let you know what are the other properties that a mat form field has. So mat form field has a property that is called appearance. So what I will do, I will provide different appearances to these all fields. Okay, so in order to show that, I will just take one input only. Okay, so this one is one mat field, mat form field. I will copy this one, paste, sorry, remove this piece of code, copy this one, paste it here, give a break, again paste it. Now there are basically four types of appearances that you can implement. Give one break here, enter. Okay, so we have four type of appearances. That is, first is legacy. Okay, second is standard, third is field itself, and after field we have outline. Okay, now you can see on the UI how these all four look like. So if you see here, right, you have this legacy input, right? Okay, right click. You have this standard input, right? So you can see how these are different from each other, right? This is a standard input. This is with some setting, right? It's fill out, its appearance is fill, and this is box, right? This is outline. Okay, so appearances are of four types. Okay, which is, I will, in order to give you a better idea, I will give it legacy. I will change the label. Okay, so legacy, standard, fill, and outline. Okay, let's go. Now this is legacy. Okay, this is a standard. Okay, and this is fill, this is outline. So these are the four different type of appearances property here. We can also have this property which will help us to provide some hint that you can provide a hint to the user. Suppose type this max 10 characters, right? Or here is the drop down arrow. So something like this you can provide. For that you need to use this mat hint. Okay, copy this mat hint. I will copy this one. Okay, this one is simple, so you can implement it. Let's go. And you need to implement this hint inside the mat form field. Okay, you need to keep this in mind. What is this? Why this is throwing error? So let's go. We will check the TS file. Come on. There is nothing here, right? So this align is, I think, the alignment. Okay, let's go. Let's see the UI. Now you can see here, right? It has this hint that is here is the drop down arrow. Okay, so this doesn't make sense to us, so let's change the text. Let's give some enter only 10 character, right? Now let's see. You can see, right? So this kind of hint you can provide to the user to have a better understanding of what they want to do with this input box. So this is one thing. Now we can also change the color of this mat form field by using property color equals to ascent or warn or primary, right? You can see, right? This legacy, the color of this legacy has been changed. So everything has been changed, right? If you see here, it is normal standard. So by default, it will take primary color. But if I have changed it, it will change to this ascent color. Okay. So in this way you can implement the form fields. So form field is basically used as a wrapper for input text area, select boxes, chips. Okay, so that's it for this video. And if you haven't subscribed our channel, please do subscribe channel and press the bell icon to get the more update. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day.